Consider the following example. Give a geometric description of the following: x squared plus y squared plus z squared plus 4x minus 2y minus 11 equals 0. Okay, so this is obviously an equation in three dimensions. And in this current form, it doesn't look like any of the special equations we've learned so far. But the fact that they're asking us to give a geometric description kind of suggests that this is some sort of special shape. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and do a little bit of algebraic manipulation to see if we can write this equation in a different form, and hopefully a form that we recognize. Okay, so what we're going to do first is I'm going to start by grouping the x terms together, the y terms together, etc. Okay, so I'm going to write this as x squared plus 4x, okay, and then plus y squared minus 2y, and then plus z squared minus 11 equals 0. Okay, so I notice that I have a quadratic or a square term in each of my variables, x, y, and z. So that fact kind of reminds me of the equation of a sphere. If you remember, the equation of a sphere looks something like this: x minus a squared plus y minus b squared plus z minus c squared equals some r squared. So maybe what I'll try to do is, in each of these sets here, maybe try to complete the square to see if I can get it to match this formula for a sphere. So let's see what happens when we do that. Okay, so to set myself up to complete the square, I'm going to go ahead and move this constant term to the other side. So this is now going to equal 11. Okay, and then maybe I'll also just go ahead and group each of these in parentheses. Now the z squared part, I'm not going to need to complete the square on that. Okay, that one's fine. It's just z squared. Okay, but let's start with x squared plus 4x. So how do we complete the square? So if you recall, well, what you're looking at is you're looking at the coefficient of the linear term. So here I'm looking at this coefficient 4, and what I'm going to do is take half of 4 and square it. So half of 4 is 2, squared is 4, and then I'm going to add that, plus 4. Now the trick is that we don't want to actually change this expression, right? We're just trying to rewrite it. So I need to balance out the change I've just made, okay? And the way I'm going to balance that out is by adding 4 to the other side of the equation. All right, and then we do the same thing for the next set of parentheses. So here I have y squared minus 2y. Once again, I'm going to look at the coefficient of the linear term. Okay, so now I'm looking at 2. Take half of 2 and square it. So half of 2 is 1, squared is 1, so I'm adding 1. And then I need to balance that out by adding 1 to the other side as well. Okay, now the whole goal of completing the square is that I want to be able to write this expression as a square. That's the whole point. So if I did this correctly, this should be the square of something. And it is. It's actually x plus 2 times x plus 2. We can check that in our heads really quick, right? That would give us x squared plus 2x plus 2x plus 4. Okay, so we're good there. Okay, so what about here with our y's? Well, this looks like it should be y minus 1 times y minus 1. And we can check that gives us y squared minus y, that's good, and then plus 1. Our z squared stands alone. And then equals over here, we've got 11 plus 4 plus 1, that's 16. So this is looking promising. So if I clean this up a little, this is x plus 2 squared plus y minus 1 quantity squared plus z squared equals 16. So now this does actually look like the equation of a sphere. Okay, so let's just describe this geometrically. So we could say this is the equation of a sphere with center at, okay, so where's the center? We'll just glance back up here one more time at our equation, our form for the equation of a sphere. And I've got these x minus a squared, y minus b squared, z minus c squared. So that's a, b, c, those are the coordinates of the center. So what's that going to give me here? Well, the x coordinate is going to be negative 2, right? X plus 2 is the same as x minus negative 2. Well, the y coordinate of the center is going to be 1. And then z is just going to be 0, right? Because here I've got essentially z minus 0 squared. Okay, so my center is at negative 2, 1, 0. And then what about the radius? Well, it's equal to r squared. Okay, so 16 is r squared. So that means the radius should be 4. So this is the equation of a sphere with center at negative 2, 1, 0. And with a radius of 4.